definitely aliens out there.
Right.
Well, the sources you sent me this time, they really make you think about a different, a darker possibility. Like,
yeah.
What if those aliens out there aren't so friendly? I mean, what if they're actually dangerous?
Yeah. It's a pretty unsettling thought, isn't it?
It is. And that's exactly what we're going to be diving into today.
Okay.
So we're going to be looking at whether alien civilizations, if they're out there, are more likely to be harmful to us than not.
I like it. Let's dive in.
All right. So one of these sources, right off the bat, comes out swinging and takes a look at human history, you know, all our wars, all the terrible things we've done to each other.
Right.
And it just straight up calls us sadistic, destructive, and barbaric.
Yeah, that's pretty blunt.
It is, but it gets even more interesting because the source doesn't just stop there. It actually goes on to argue that all this bad stuff we've done, it's not just some random fluke. It might actually be like baked into our biology somehow.
That's a really interesting idea. And it's where this concept of a psychopathic structure comes in. Now, and this is important. It's not about saying that everyone is a psychopath or that we're all clinically diagnosed with some kind of disorder.
Yeah.
It's talking about a kind of societal pattern. It's saying that individuals who have traits we might associate with psychopathy, you know, like a lack of empathy or maybe a tendency to manipulate others, those individuals are actually more likely to end up in positions of power.
Wow.
And the really radical idea here is that this isn't just bad luck or, you know, bad ideology. It could be something deeper. It could be driven by our biology, by the way we've evolved.
So it's not just that we have bad leaders, it's that our whole system might be set up to put people with these kinds of traits in charge.
Yeah, that's kind of the implication here.
Right.
And the source takes it even a step further.
Okay, how so?
Well, it draws this really interesting parallel to natural selection.
Mm-hmm.
We all know how natural selection works, right? It's survival of the fittest competition drives evolution.
Right.
So the source asks this kind of mind-blowing question. What if you took another species here on Earth, like chimpanzees or even ants?
Okay.
And you gave them advanced technology, would they end up going down the same path as us?
Oh, wow. So you're saying that if evolution favors those kinds of traits in us, then maybe it would favor them in other until you.
Exactly. It's like this unsettling possibility that this evilness, as the source calls it, might not be just a human problem, but like a universal problem, a consequence of how life itself develops. C.o.T line stands for, well, the source doesn't really say what it stands for exactly, but it represents this hypothetical point in a civilization's development, this turning point, where they reach a level of understanding of biology and genetics, that they can actually start to significantly reduce or maybe even eliminate these psychopathy traits that we've been talking about.
Whoa, hold on. So you're saying that we could potentially engineer ourselves or maybe evolve naturally to a point where those harmful tendencies...
Yeah, it's a huge idea, right? It's not just about having better technology or, you know, more enlightened leaders. This is about fundamentally changing our nature, changing who we are at a biological level.
That's mind-blowing. And what does the source say about how civilizations on either side of this line, like those who've crossed it and those who haven't, how would they interact with each other?
Okay, so the source paints this really fascinating picture of the future. It says that civilizations who've crossed this line, they're called psychopathy-free, or PFs.
PFs, okay.
They might be able to recognize each other, you know, maybe through certain signals or behaviors, and they'd be much more likely to engage in peaceful cooperation.
Right.
But on the other hand, they might look at civilizations that haven't crossed the line yet, so civilizations with psychopathy, or WPs.
Okay, got it. PFs and WPs.
Exactly. And they might see them as dangerous, as a threat to be avoided at all costs.
So it's like once you cross that line, you suddenly become a lot more cautious about who you hang out with in the galactic neighborhood.
Yeah, kind of like that. It's all about self-preservation, right?
Yeah.
If you're a civilization that's managed to overcome these harmful tendencies, you don't want to risk getting pulled back into those old patterns of conflict and exploitation.
Makes sense. But what about those WP civilizations, the ones that haven't crossed the line yet? What happens?
Well, the source suggests that they might actually become more and more isolated.
Really? How come?
Well, because of their inherent distrust of others and their potentially aggressive tendencies, other civilizations might just choose to stay away.
So it's like they're putting themselves in a cosmic timeout.
In a way, yeah.
Yeah.
And this isolation could have some serious consequences. It could lead to technological stagnation or even regression because they're not benefiting from the kind of collaboration and knowledge sharing that's happening.
Oh, wow. So crossing the C.o.T. line isn't just about becoming nicer. It could actually give you a huge advantage in the long run.
Exactly. It's like a cosmic fast track for civilizations that have gotten their act together, at least biologically.
Okay, so how does all of this tie into our search for extraterrestrial intelligence?
That's a great question, and here's where it gets even more mind-blowing. The source suggests that advanced alien civilizations, the ones that are way ahead of us technologically,
okay,
they might actually be intentionally avoiding contact with us.
Why would they do?
Because they're looking at us and seeing a WP civilization, a civilization that's still on the wrong side of that line.
So basically they're looking down at us and saying, nope, not ready for prime time.
Kind of like that, yeah. Our history, all the wars and violence, it might be sending out a signal that we're just too risky to engage with.
So it's like a cosmic do not disturb sign.
Exactly. But there's a flip side to it. If humanity can manage to cross the C.o.T. line,
okay,
it could dramatically increase our chances of making contact with those more advanced PF civilizations.
Because then we'd be seen as less of a threat and more like potential partners.
Precisely. It's like we'd finally be invited to the galactic party.
Tendencies.
Yeah, exactly. We could potentially use things like biological treatments, stress monitoring, early intervention programs, to help those kids develop in a healthier way.
That's amazing. So we might actually have the power to break this cycle.
That's the idea. And the source believes that this could have huge implications for society as a whole, not just in terms of reducing crime, but in terms of changing the very fabric of our culture.
Okay, so if this psychopathy is so potentially harmful, why would evolution even favor it in the first place?
Well, that's a great question. And the source actually acknowledges that these traits might have some hidden benefits.
Really? What kind of benefits?
Well, for example, someone with those traits might be really good at making tough decisions under pressure. They might be really analytical and detached, which could be useful in certain fields, like science or finance.
So in certain contexts, those traits could actually be an advantage.
Right. But the source is also very clear that the overall impact of what it calls the psychopathic structure is negative.
Okay, what?
Well, the source argues that even if only a small percentage of people actually express these traits really strongly, they can still have a huge influence on society as a whole.
How so?
Well, because they often end up in positions of power, and they can be very good at manipulating others into supporting them, even if those people don't share those same traits.
So they're kind of like puppet masters pulling the strings from behind the scenes.
Yeah, kind of like that. And this creates a system where a lot of people end up collaborating with or even serving those who are exploiting them.
That's pretty bleak.
Yeah, it is. But the source also suggests that this might be a kind of evolutionary balancing act.
What do you mean?
Well, it says that the genes for these traits are probably quite widespread in the population. It might even be helpful in small doses.
Okay, so it's like everyone has the potential for these traits, but only a few people actually express them strongly.
Exactly. And the source suggests that natural selection might have favored this kind of arrangement, because it allows a society to benefit from those traits in certain situations without everyone becoming completely cutthroat and ruthless.
That's fascinating. So it's like evolution is trying to strike a balance between cooperation and competition.
Precisely. It's a delicate.
Okay, so earlier you mentioned that this source proposes a new way of categorizing aliens, so tell me more.
Oh yeah, this is where things get really interesting. So we all know about the Kardashev scale, right? It's that famous scale that measures a civilization's technological advancement based on how much energy they can harness.
Right.
But this source says that maybe we need a different kind of scale altogether.
Okay, what kind of scale?
A scale that looks at a civilization's relationship to its own biology.
Oh, wow. So instead of just looking at how much energy they use, we're looking at how they've managed to deal with these psychopathic tendencies.
Exactly. And the source proposes a really simple two-step scale. On one side, you have civilizations that are still dominated by that psychopathic structure. Those are the WPs.
Right.
And on the other side, you have the civilizations that have managed to overcome or bypass those tendencies.
The PFS.
Exactly. And this new scale would be all about identifying which side of the C.o.T. line a civilization has reached.
So it's like a measure of their biological maturity.
Yeah, I guess you could say that. It's about how well they've managed to control or eliminate those potentially destructive impulses.
Okay, so let's say a civilization does manage to cross the C.o.T. line. What does that actually, is it like paradise?
Well, the source doesn't paint it as a utopia. It acknowledges that there would still be challenges and conflicts.
Right.
But it does predict some pretty significant changes. For example, crime rates would probably drop dramatically.
Yeah.
Economic cycles would become more stable and less prone to boom and bust.
So overall, a more peaceful and predictable world.
Yeah, I think that's a fair assessment. But the source also points out that basic human needs wouldn't just disappear. People would still experience boredom. They'd still crave challenge. They'd still search for meaning.
So what are you saying? That even in a world without war and crime, we'd still find something to worry about?
Well, yeah, kind of.
Yeah.
The source even speculates that people might actually seek out new forms of suffering or challenge to replace the old ones.
Really? Give me an example.
Well, maybe instead of fighting wars, we'd have these really intense philosophical debates, or maybe we'd push ourselves to the limit in extreme sports or creative pursuits.
So it's like we'd channel that energy that used to go into violence and destruction into something more constructive.
Yeah, exactly. It's like we'd find new ways to test ourselves, new ways to grow.
That's a really interesting thought. So even though crossing the C.o.T. line wouldn't be a magical fix, it could still lead to a much better world. These sources have given us a whole new way of looking at the universe, at ourselves, and at the potential for life beyond Earth.
They really have. It's a perspective that's both challenging and inspiring.
And on that note, here's a final thought for all of you listening out there. Think about everything we've discussed today, and then ask yourself this. How does this change the way you view? Does it make you see the patterns of war and peace in a new light?
Yeah.
And if we were to pick up a signal from a distant star, what kind of clues should we be looking for to try and figure out if that civilization has crossed its own C.o.T. line?
That's a great question.
Thanks for joining us on this deep dive, folks. We'll see you next time.